In this video, we are going to explain how to make reports with Skelion. We insert panels in these two roofs with a 180 and 30 degree orientation, and in these two we insert them coplanar. So we have two roofs with identical panel orientations. This one with an azimuth of 198 degrees. And that one with an azimuth of 108 degrees. With array view, we can mark now some strings if we want. We must give color to each instance. In this example, we paint only two arrays. Array view creates a new component in the model and changes all instances for this new white component. We can see it in the component window. It has the same name but with the ending blank. To make the report, we click Array View again. Let's make the report to see how many panels we have. We have four roofs, but only three different orientations, so we have three groups. One group joins the two roofs with the same panel orientation, and the other two groups are the two coplanar roofs. We painted two arrays that we can see here. After calculating the report, Skelion saves the information in each roof. With the face report tool, we can see this information. Therefore, we must choose one face. And we can see the stored information. We can change the name if we want. For example, we can put house. Recalculate, and then we can see that the name has changed. We can delete panels, but face report is not updated. It has the panel number of the last time we clicked report. We must update it recalculating the report. And now it is correct. With PVGIS and PVWatts, we can calculate the yield of a PV system. We are also going to do a shading derate calculation, so we need a typical meteorological year, TMY. This is an example. So we take the first option, but the meteor station is 100 km away from the model, so the shading derate is not going to be very accurate. Now we can use PVGIS. The model is geolocated in Europe. This tool opens the PVGIS webpage. We can send the three groups, the four faces, or the two arrays. Groups is a good choice because Skelion will also show the report of arrays and faces, interpolating group results. Now the webpage for the first group appears. We must click Search to locate PVGIS. We can change any value. Skelion has changed estimated losses 14% by default because we calculate the shading derate. We close the windows and do the same for the other two groups. The report is finished. Skelion has interpolated the results from the groups to faces and arrays. Estimated losses are not 14% now because we choose the shading derate calculation. Let's try PVWatts. In this case, we'll send only two arrays for the web to the web page, and we are not going to calculate the shading rate. This is array 1, we can change the losses if we want. If we had checked the shading rate, this value would be different. Our model is very far from the station that PVWatts uses to make calculations. So we cannot trust very much in these results. 30 km, more or less, would be a good distance. We can see in the report that the station is 100 km away from the model. The export shading rate tool allows us to export values to other software like the System Advisor model. We can select, for example, groups to make three files, one for each group. We name it, and Skelion will save three files that you can see here. You can edit them with any text editor. Thank you for watching.